Hi guys, my name's Carly and I'm from Elkhorn High School. And my poem is called Fragile. A dusty white ranch style home with shutters black as night. At the backyard fence, a puppy wagging its tail 50 miles per hour. On the windowsill, a football of brown and gray. The siding worn looks as old as Gandalf the Grey. Our wooden porch swing sways in the breeze. Beyond, beautiful petunias and snapdragons blossoming bright as moonlight. On late Friday nights, Mom comes home from work, the box company, dressed in black slacks, purple blouse, tiny black heels, and a red bottle in hand. She changes into pajamas, soft as a cloud, plops down into her spot on the couch, pours the wine to a charming glass passed down from her father. We giggle like young girls over their crushes, sounding like happy little fairies, her smile easy as melted butter over bread. Dad comes up from the dungeon, frowning, his brow furrowing. He screams like two demons in combat, "You're destroying this family with your addiction." His voice sends me running to my messy room, forces bright pink earbuds into my ears, music as loud as a rock concert to tune it all out. Tears run down my face. They won't stop. At 2 a.m, I can't sleep. His voice still echoing through the walls, my body still convulsing with sobs. In the morning, I have NSBA, the biggest marching band competition of the year. On the field, I am running off of anger and 5 hours of sleep because nothing is good enough for him. I am barely able to stand still as we are waiting to begin. Irritation flowing through my veins, a slow burn within my heart. I breathe in, I breathe out, let it go. 13 minutes pass by like a bullet. I don't even think of last night. I give my best performance of the season. Exiting the stadium, I spot my mother. She actually showed up. Rage begins to boil, but I push it back down. She's trying her hardest. This isn't her fault. It was his voice that continued to echo throughout the night. We embrace, and over, she tells me how amazing we were, her hands moving as she fumbles over her words. She pulls me aside, placing her hand delicately on my arm, like I'm made of fragile materials, and says, "I'm so sorry, last night shouldn't have ended like that." With tears in my eyes, I pull her into an embrace so tight she can barely breathe, and tell her, "Mom, it's not your fault."